A storm is brewing in the American coal industry, and it's about to get even more serious.
Since 2015, six of the nation's top coal producers have declared bankruptcy, and now it appears another industry giant may soon follow suit. Westmoreland Coal, which owns coal mines in Montana, Wyoming, North Dakota, and Texas, along with mines in Alberta and Saskatchewan, is teetering on the brink of bankruptcy.
The company's misfortune comes on the heels of a miserable performance in 2017. Tonight, much more on Westmoreland's struggles and why Montana has plenty at stake in the company's future.
A new report this month from the Institute for Energy Economics details how the fortunes of Westmoreland Coal have turned sour and suggests the company is in serious trouble. Westmoreland is the sixth largest North American coal producer, reporting $1.5 billion in revenue in 2016 and 3,200 employees. But it's been losing money quarter after quarter as far back as 2012. Over the past 12 months, Westmoreland's stock has lost 97% of its value, and the company is well over $1 billion in debt.
Clearly, investors and Wall Street are not thrilled with the performance of the company, but their credit rating has been falling. It's in junk territory, triple C.
Westmoreland owns three Montana coal mines, the Rosebud Mine at Colstrip, the Absolica Mine near Hardin, and the Savage Mine near the Montana-North Dakota border. Energy data analyst Seth Feaster, who authored the report, says the company's struggles are the result of a wholesale shift in America's energy scene.
All across this country, a lot of utilities, based on the demands of their customers and the costs inherent in coal-fired power, are moving away from coal. And one of the biggest problems for coal is cheap natural gas. That's really, there's a lot of talk about regulation being the problem, but really cheap natural gas from fracking is what's doing in coal right now.
In spite of its troubles, Westmoreland wants to expand its Rosebud mine near Colstrip. Just before Christmas, in fact, Interior Secretary Ryan Zinke's office announced approval of the mine's 60-ton expansion, only to backtrack a day later, saying that announcement was an error. Following the false report, Westmoreland's stock price enjoyed a brief rebound.
The owners of Colstrip have done analyses. It is the most expensive mine around, and it's because it's been around so long. You cherry pick. They started out picking the best coal closest to the surface, closest to the plant, where they could put it on a conveyor belt. It was cheap. As they've aged, they've moved further and further away into areas that they never really expected to mine that have really serious overburden, which means you have to take a lot of dirt off. They have water quality problems like nobody's business.
Ann Hedges with the Montana Environmental Information Center in Helena has been advocating against new coal development her entire career.
Are we going to let a company that is trading at 60 cents a share have a giant expansion of a mine to feed a plant that you know the owners are not going to be there in 10, 15 years? And they're talking about a mine expansion that's going to take them out into the late 2040s. Who's going to pay for that? It's going to be the customers of these utilities who are paying for that. And I don't want to pay for something that I'm not going to use. I don't think anybody wants to pay for something they're not going to use. And I certainly don't want to have to pay to clean up something that I never used. And that's where we're headed.
Numerous attempts to contact Westmoreland for comment regarding the story went unanswered. And perhaps that's because the company is under new leadership. Back in November, CEO Kevin Paprzycki resigned suddenly after the company reported losses totaling $107 million through the first three quarters of 2017.